Hi, everyone. Welcome to a brand spanking new Academy series. That's right. We're going to focus on the last device Vectornator is available on, your iPhone. Vectornator basically functions the same, but here's how you can make the best of our app using a smaller screen. Today, we're focusing on the interface. Once you open Vectornator, you immediately jump into the home screen. The home screen is divided into 5 sections. Up here, we can see the 2 locations where you can store your files. This little guy here is the Help menu, where you can make feature requests, join conversations on our forum, or brush up on your knowledge from our extensive learning hub. Down here, you can go to our news section, where we post new updates, trends, interviews, and so on. If you're a design geek, I definitely recommend you give it a read. The Learn tab, on the other hand, is jam-packed with tutorials from beginners to advanced that will help to design and illustrate with vectors. If you want to teach yourselves how to use our tools, for example, just tap and pick whatever topic you'd like. If you're a visual learner, then go to our Academy section. We go through every functionality in our app, one video at a time. In Settings, at the very top, you can check what version of Vectornator you have installed. Make sure you're always up to date. From Preferences, you can see general settings, like switching between light and dark mode, for example. So let's do just that. I'm definitely a dark mode type of user. Moving on, let's look at the files stored on my iPhone first. Here I can see all the sample files that we put at everyone's disposal to use, edit, and play around with. If we scroll down to the very bottom, you can see the total number of files as well as the available space remaining on your device. By clicking on this expandable menu here, I can multi-select files by simply tapping on them once. And then I can move them to iCloud if I want, create a folder containing my selection, or delete them in bulk. Okay, we're done here for now, so let's see what iCloud is all about. The iCloud drive is the section that synchronizes all your documents across your devices. So whatever documents I see here are also on my iPad and Mac. Super nifty when switching devices, designing on the go, or clearing up space on your iPhone. Bear in mind that if you see this iCloud icon in the upper right corner, it means that your files have not yet been downloaded. So just tap on it once, and now the file is ready to be edited. To keep things organized, you might want to create various folders for your projects. This is how folders look, while these are my standalone files. To create folders, we have 2 ways. One, you can create a new folder from the pop-up menu we saw before. 2, you can simply drag and drop one file on top of the other and our folder is automatically generated. To edit an individual document, long press to access this expandable menu, which allows you to rename, duplicate, share, and all that jazz. The options are pretty self-explanatory. And let's say I don't want this illustration to be in this folder. What I can do is long press on the file, then with a second finger, go back to the main iCloud area and drop it anywhere I want. Okay, we've seen everything about our old documents, but let's move on to the new. Tap on plus to create a fresh new document. Either import a file from Photos, Camera, Figma, yes, we do have a Figma integration, or you can choose any of our super useful templates that get you started with any design project right away. Our document templates are divided into multiple categories depending on what type of project you're working on. To see all categories at one glance, simply tap this menu right here. Let's say I want to create a story for my Instagram account. As soon as you tap on the template, a new document opens in the correct size you need. And this is what the UI of my workspace looks like. Very similar to what we see on the iPad. It's a very minimal interface designed to give you as much creative real estate as possible. And it's divided into 3 main sections. At the very top, we see Settings, Import, Undo, Redo, and Zoom Level. In one word, our widget area. On the left, we have our toolbar that gives you access to all our available tools in Vectornator. On the right side instead, we have the Action bar. And the inspector is hidden under this arrow here, which when opened, reveals all its 5 subtabs. Since the inspector covers our entire screen in vertical mode, when creating, I strongly recommend you tilt your phone horizontally. This way, we're going to be using our screen more efficiently. Now the interface changed a bit. The inspector is on the right, as per usual, which leaves plenty of room for me to work on my canvas. The top will now also include the action bar. And on the left, nothing changed. Let's look at preferences for a moment. Here, you can customize what you want to see. So for example, I usually remove the ruler, guides, and dimensions because I think my working space will look much cleaner as a result. Or if you want to change your quick settings, we just need to go here. And then pick and choose whatever suits our project or workflow. When we go back to our canvas, we can see that my grid disappeared and my quick settings have changed as well. To see all of our content-aware functionalities, I'm going to pull up an artwork from our sample files. This one is from the amazing Jaye Kang. And let's take a moment to notice the frosted glass effect on the inspector's side. And when I move or edit my illustration, the interface automatically becomes very, very dim. All these features are meant to pull all your focus into your creative process. No distractions. At least, not from our interface. But if you prefer having the interface visible at all times, go back to Quick Settings and deactivate the Magic Canvas feature. I definitely prefer keeping Magic Canvas on. And I'm going to show you in our next tutorial how this impacts my workflow. In our next video, we're going to go through the basics of designing on your iPhone. Ultimately, things behave as you'd expect if you have experience working on your iPad. I can edit my nodes by dragging them around. Then from the Style tab, I can play with my fill color. The Style tab also has all my node types. From the Arrange tab, I'm able to flip objects, align and order them in various ways, and so on. The Path tab is responsible for path editing options. Here are our beautiful new layers. The last tab is the library itself, divided into 5 subtabs, which allow you to import files, SF symbols, or icons through Iconator. There are more than 80,000 available, so I'm sure you're going to find the search bar super useful. Last on the list is Unsplash, which gives you access to royalty-free images straight from our app. In our next video, we're going to look at all the basic operations, like, for example, undo. If you want to undo any action, just tap the canvas once with 2 fingers. Or you can redo by tapping with 3 fingers instead. But more on gestures and basic operations up next. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and click on the next video to keep on learning. Bye-bye.